Hello everyone. Today we're going to be talking about, it's going to get to the point. So, I was asked recently, how do I save my game in series? And now there are two options. Now I'm going to show you first the way you go about it naturally, and second, alternative way where you can go about it where absolutely sure that you're going to have your save game. So, I'm going to turn on my pen tool and it has to do with these two things right here. Now, this one at the top has to do with uploading your game to cloud storage. And in order to upload your save game to cloud storage, you'll first need to have one of these, which is a Google Play Games account. Now, all you just do, once you have this, you just upload it to your Google Play game save file. So every time when you log in, like say you lost all of your file, and you will have this backup to go to, because it will prompt you to go to this backup once you start up the game fresh and you have an internet connection. I don't think it would come up naturally if you don't, but if you have an internet connection, it will like just load the past save. And I will go into the save to show you. Give me a second. So as you can see, there are, I think I have 3 saves right now, 4, 5, 6, 7, and these are saves. Well, I think there's one that is like in 2018. No, I must have deleted it. I have, this is today's game. This is saved game at, yeah, this is saved today. This is 2020. This was in 2019. So I am a little bit paranoid with the saving, but like that, and you can save as much as you want, and you can delete what you don't want and stuff like that, and make a fresh new save, which is probably what I'm gonna do soon. So that's how you basically save with that way. But there's another way, and I'll show you outside of the game. But first, I like to sidestep and talk about this. Now, this current setup, I tried out the top speed that the car is at. If you want to check out the end of the video, you'll see how it goes. Now, I'm just gonna go back out and show you the second way to save, and then we'll come back. Now the second way to save is to go to your storage, go to Android, and go to data, and then go all the way down and search for com.therise street racing, which is right here. And once you find this, you just zip it and then put it somewhere safe, or you can just copy this file in general and put it somewhere safe. But zipping it and putting it somewhere safe is better, in ways that it won't show up in your gallery once you do that away. So that's the other way. And if I can show you, I could go back. And where is it? Where is it? My career. So I have all the saves. I have the after purchase one. I have a normal one, which was not zipped. I have another one. So this see what I have for December 2020 and stuff like that. So there's a lot. That's just the two ways you can save. And then I have all my cars saved as well. So for my cars, I have all of them listed, the names and stuff like that. They're saved. And in order to save your cars, it's pretty simple. All you just need to do, you just go to data and, wait a minute, I don't have to go to data. You go to data and go back to that file, but it's like, I'm gonna use this as an example. So current file, no, the one that's not zip. You go into files, and then you have your cars right here. And all this, you just copy it and put it where you want to back up your car files. And then that's how you save your cars, just in case of anything happening at all. So that is another option for you. So if you like, well, it's not really relevant now, because Because in the game now you can have up to as much card space as you wanted, but before when you only have 10, it was a very useful feature. Right now it's like, nah. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoy. And now I'll talk about the card itself and what I'm going to do. Now, before I start this, I must mute audio. Now, the card itself, like, it's pretty good. I don't know if the 324 meters per hour is the top speed that I want it to be going. I can see myself like putting it down lower. Now, the thing that I'm going to do after this is, well, this for this recording in particular, I'm going to like stress test it without nitro and then with nitro, and then see like what gears I need to put up to go a little faster, what gears need to be going a little bit slower, stuff like that. So that's just it. It's gonna take a while to like tune this car properly to what I want it to be doing, but it works really good so far. So let's get right into it. The first gear take a very long time to get up, so that needs to be changed, and all the other gears seem very long, so I can definitely see me pulling it back down to about 305 kilometers per hour top speed or something like that. So we'll see. The 305 seems like a pretty good idea, but we must have that in mind once we finish this. And this, if this is not what I like, then probably let me change it. Alright, that's about it. It works pretty good for heavy racing, it seems. Not really. It's like, it looked like it's set up for it. And looking at this tune, once you like set it up so that it can match up perfectly, it will make the all gears basically extremely long. So I'm thinking that 324 is not the way, because it's just gonna be too I'll have to think about it. I can't just go on my impulses and bring down the speed to 305 kilometers per hour. So we're just gonna test our runs with 324 and then tune it to what I think it would likely be and see how it is. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you guys next time.